From the Tribune News Network, this is Newsbreak. I'm Krishna Russell. An urgent appeal was filed yesterday asking the court to consider extending a 2018 injunction barring the government from evicting shantytown residents and disconnecting services in their communities. The move came as Minister of Works Desmond Bannister promised relentless and decisive action will be taken in an Abaco shantytown before the end of the month. Attorney Martin Lundy II said an application filed in January 2020 by Respect Our Homes Limited and 177 residents and occupants of shanty towns concerned a matter of urgency because if it was not heard, there was a real possibility that the government would destroy or seize the homes of applicants in Abaco before the proceedings were heard and adjudicated. A shooting in a home in Baynetown left a 10-year-old boy dead and two other children in hospital. A man who was shot during the incident is also in hospital. The shooting was one of two incidents that occurred within the span of about 2 hours last night. Around 11 p.m., police were called to a second homicide scene in Fox Hill. Regarding the first matter, police said shortly after 9 p.m., they were called to the scene of a shooting incident in Baynetown. Four people, an adult male and three children, whose ages range from 7 to 10 years old, were injured. In this incident, here we had four persons shot, Assistant Commissioner of Police Solomon Cash said. One of the males succumbed, and there were two other males, juvenile males, who were also shot along with an adult. Asked about the condition of the three victims in hospital, he said the victims who were in hospital were being treated for their injuries. ACP Cash said the victims were shot in their home. Police could not say if the incident was a domestic one, adding that officers were still investigating to determine the motive. Anyone with information is asked to contact police at 502-9991-911 or 919. Prime Minister Dr. Hubert Minnis has denied telling Standard & Poor that the government will host an election this year. Progressive Liberal Party leader Philip Brave Davis made the claim that the agency had been alerted to an election during his contribution to the mid-year budget debate in the House of Assembly on Wednesday. The Standard & Poor's 10-page report contains two references to an upcoming election. In one instance, the rating agency said it does not expect progress on fiscal reforms given the ongoing pandemic and upcoming election. A woman who had been missing since last week was found yesterday in the Stapleton Gardens area. Police were called after Nicholas Sobey, 43, came to a home in the area seeking help. Police released a missing persons poster for Ms. Sobey on Tuesday, saying she was last seen in the area of Frederick Street on March 4th. In a Facebook post, a relative thanked members of the public who raised awareness of Ms. Sobey's disappearance and asked for privacy now that she has been found. After COVID-19 sparked a year-long halt of the cruise line industry, in international news, the city of Minneapolis today agreed to pay $27 million to settle a civil lawsuit from George Floyd's family over the black man's death in police custody as jury selection continued in a former officer's murder trial. The Minneapolis City Council emerged from a closed session to announce the settlement. Floyd's family attorney, Ben Crump, called a news conference for 1 p.m. that was to include family members. Crump, in a prepared statement, said it was the largest pretrial civil rights settlement ever and sends a powerful message that black lives do matter and police brutality against people of color must end. Officials in several European countries pushed back today against decisions by others to pause use of AstraZeneca's coronavirus vaccine following sporadic reports of blood clots, despite a lack of evidence the shot was responsible. German Health Minister Jens Spahn said that while the country takes reports of possible harmful effects from vaccines very, very seriously, both the European Medicines Agency and Germany's own vaccine oversight body have said they have no evidence of an increase in dangerous blood clots in connection with the shots. The Tribune's AccuWeather update, a service of Bahamas Power and Light Company. A strong high-pressure system centered north of the area will continue to support brisk winds across the islands today. Small craft operators should remain in port. Beachgoers should also refrain from entering the water due to rough surf and dangerous rip currents across all areas. Motorists and pedestrians should exercise extreme caution while traversing coastal roads, especially the Glass Window Bridge and the Fishing Hole Road, due to adverse weather conditions. In the northwest Bahamas, Bahamas, it'll be partly cloudy to cloudy, breezy, and warm, with the chance of a few quick passing showers today. Mostly fair and mild, with a few spotty showers tonight. Small craft operators should remain in port. Winds northeast to east at 15 to 25 knots, but gusty at times over open waters. Seas 6 to 9 feet, but higher in gusts, and moderate to large north to northeasterly swells. In the central and southeast Bahamas, it'll be partly to mostly cloudy, warm, and windy, with a few passing showers through tonight. Small craft operators should remain in port. Winds northeast to east at 20 to 25 knots, but gusty at times over open waters. Seas 7 to 11 feet, but higher in gusts, and moderate to large north to northeasterly swells. We'll have a daytime high temperature of 81 degrees and an overnight low temperature of 70. The sun will set this afternoon at 6:16 and will rise tomorrow morning at 6:22.